There is existence. No, but there is a I feeling is only a thought only, that I am existing.
The thought is pointing to something existing. The thought is always a pointer.
Expression. Yeah. It is expressing that there is existence.
That's I only.
When you say I, means there is others also.
No. The others also existence only. From, if I am existence,
there is no I other.
So that's only existence, sir. Over that name and form are put.
Now you are saying existence over that forms are put. Where is forms are coming from?
That you will find out.
you are interchanging the awareness and existence.
Awareness and existence are the same thing. Sat, Chit, Ananda. They are not different.
Aware is knowing. Knowing. First you told that knowing is only that thought says that knowing.
No. Thought is saying not knowing. Knowing. Thought appears in the front of knowing. I know that there is thought. I know that there is no thought.
So, first discussion we had, no seeing part. When we say that there is no seer or seen, only seeing is there. And you told that no, even the seeing is not there. Only thought after that seeing, that is after sometimes the thought says that seeing was happening. So there is no actual seeing. So thought is only telling that seeing.
There is an experience is there. The experience is cut into seer and seen by the thought.
Ah, correct.
Right? There is experiencing happening.
But when the experience is happening, there is no experience. Only after that thought is telling, experience happened.
When this experience is happening, there is only bliss.
What is bliss?
Mind is silent, there is bliss.
But there is no experience of bliss. Because we can't experience bliss.
That's called
no
bliss.
Experience happening.
No experience, silence is called bliss. So you can't experience bliss separately.
What is useful?
That is useful when you are noisy. Mind is noisy. No noise is blissful.
That for that you need to experience that bliss.
You are experiencing.
But there is no experience. When there is no experience, then only bliss is.
There's no experiencer. The experience is coming later. Experiencing is happening. That's why I'll take experience and experiencing separately. Because there's a confusion about that.
You are telling seeing, knowing, experience are a single thing. There's no difference between, right?
Seeing is experiencing.
Huh.
And experiencing is knowing.
Knowing, correct. When that knowing is happening, actually happening, at that time there's no seer or seeing.
Okay. They are one.
So one. At that time you told that it is a bliss state. But then thought comes and says that
disturbs your bliss.
Yeah. So I am seeing that seeing something happening and I am there and there's other.
And this I am is a memory.
That it is telling.
I am is a memory, it's not real. It's a past.
Then only I will say that I experience bliss. Like after deep sleep I say that I experience deep sleep.
Exactly.
At that deep sleep that is that where
exactly.
Nothing.
Exactly.
Nothing.
Exactly, that's what's happening. So are we clear? Any doubts? Hey Pratibha, are you clear? So, if all this understood, what happens to your life? Okay, so now, what is happening is, what you call as the world, okay, is coming to us through five senses, visual, auditory, kinesthetic, olfactory, and gustatory. Okay, then the brain and mind, this mind operates on the brain, I don't say separate brain and mind, they will actually make some something for calculations, they do some deletions, right? Something unwanted pictures, they remove. Okay, then they will distort also sometimes, and there's generalization also. So for example, this finger, is my finger is added there, it's not there. So then it will store in the form of images, sound, feeling and senses and tastes.
So all, there are five kinds of thoughts basically.
Now it's five kinds of sensations. Five kinds of sensations. Mm-hmm. Finally, you store in terms of words, name.
Or images also.
Images.
Yeah. So images and name you associate. Name and form you associate. So already it has gone through a lot of changes before it really gets stored. Right?
So suppose I smell something, then that memory of what smell that is will
Yeah, so
at the surface. So it is like a smell thought.
It is a name and form. I call it all the smell, taste, sound and everything as a form. It is, the name is given to that. The name and form will surface. But what is stored there and what is reality is completely different.
Concept of there is separate world from there.
No. See, this is actually, see, if I say nothing is there, then nothing will.
But you told that.
It's only for explanation purpose. Right? Explanation purpose we have to take and split. Otherwise, no explanation is possible. Right? So, what is stored here is what you are experiencing. Right? Isn't it? Now, what is stored here, in here, is just a representation of what is there, and what is there also is not real, because that's also the elephant you never see. So you are seeing something, a story, a part of that, and whole of your life you think that this is the reality. You are not able to see the elephant, you are seeing only fan, you are seeing the what is it,
tail.
And that also your mind is, while storing it, is cuts into pieces and makes it to something very, very small, small pieces, and that you stores, and your entire life you are leaving this as your reality.
Non-editing perfect.
Non-edit
made perfect.
Non-edit made perfect. You understand?
Sir, this deletion, distortion, sensing, these are reality? You told that, okay. Okay, but you told that actual something, real existence is it? And there is distorted to this, but that distortion is actually happening.
Even you look at your own experience, no? You tell me, no? Yeah, you had a breakfast yesterday, 10 days back?
Yes.
What breakfast did you have? You describe. So distorted. There's a memory that I had a breakfast, is there?
But this distortion is reality then.
You mean, you go by your own experience, no? Are you able to show exactly high definition image of everything?
You say only absolute is reality. So
see, don't mix up these things. Absolute reality is when you reach there. Right now you are in the relative. If you have reached the absolute, there is no discussion. Right? If you are speaking from a point of absolute, there is no discussion at all. Right? One discussion is silence.
Okay, distortion, that is all happening. Okay. Changes are happening. Right.
Yeah, it is so much happening. So much changes happen now.
I think there's a mix-up. What he probably means is distortion of fact, not reality. He's trying to distortion is a fact. It is happening. Whether it is real.
No, sir. Why I am telling, because absolute we say that can't change. Nothing happen. It is. Distortion happening means that means there is some.
No. I'm saying don't answer from my point of view. Answer your point of view. From anything has happened to your eye. 20 years back, 30 years back, now I has it changed?
This eye
has changed, but whatever you say as I, has it changed?
I never changed.
So that's what is absolute.
That is absolute, but distortion is happening. That is real.
Is absolute got distorted?
No.
So that's what it is. There's absolute and relative. We are speaking in the domain of relative. If you are speaking in the absolute domain, there's I. There's nothing is to speak also.
There is real, there is also unreal also. That is also real.
Unreal is also real.
Real means that it is there or not. Like, I will say that somebody is there. There is a dog, there is no dog. It's not a real. It's unreal. So, if you say that Maya or unreal or some distortion or all these things, appearances, it is there or not there? If it is there, means it is also real.
So, you went to Paris in your dream. Is Paris real?
At the moment of dreaming, it is there.
Same answer.
When you wake up, that is unreal.
The answer is same.
But at the both time, real is there. That is, existence is there.
Existence is already there.
Always there.
Right?
After waking up, how are you managing real and unreal?
That is the fun. Right? So, you understood now what's happening. Right? The time is compressed in our memory. Just visualize your childhood, What happened in your childhood? In 1 second you will be able to visualize, because all the childhood of 20 years is 10 years is compressed into 1 second. Is it distortion?
Distortion, yes.
Right? So can you remember the details very clearly?
Maybe some of it. It's a distortion.
Faint memory.
It's a distortion.
Faint memory.
So everything is a faint. Now, but we start living that as real. How many times you cry about what happened in life? Do you? Huh? How many times you keep on cursing, oh, I should not have done this, regret? Everything is just an image here. What it has got to do you? Who are you now? One who is seeing the image, not the image. One who is aware of this. For one who is aware of this, nothing is happening. And that is Brahman. That is Sakshi, that's you.
Remembering is happening also.
Remembering, what is remembering also? Another chakra, sir. So there's another dangerous pitfall.
Thought is happening.
Thought is happening. Right? So there is a subject and object. Both are in the mind. Okay? And the mind is in consciousness. Nothing is happening to consciousness because you know very well that nothing has changed. Then what is the drama, all this drama is going on?
Drama
entertainment.
Drama only.
It's exactly like what happened in the dream. In your dream, you went to Paris. You did a shopping. Right? You got into a flight. Then you wake up. No Paris, no dream girl, no Eiffel Tower. That's exactly what is happening now. This is another dream. This dream is called Maya. What happens by knowing this dream is a Maya? Will your life change?
We can keep the dream as a dream, not nightmare.
You'll enjoy the dream also.
Two things will happen. One of two things will happen.
Is it in our?
Who is? Then you say who is in our means who's we? Who's which is which I?
No, that's all. It's not there. You can't prove it. even if I realize that I'm self, so whatever is happening, I don't have any control. So it will happen. So
who is it I?
The real I
is bothered about it?
Nothing.
So I don't have control, is nothing, irrelevant.
So there is good, there is change or not, it's not going to affect the I anyway.
It is not going to affect I, but right now you are suffering, I am suffering in life.
But even then suffering can happen.
For whom?
For nothing. Suffering is a thought that, yeah, I'm suffering, that thought can go on.
So, right now, so far you are bothered that I am suffering. Now nothing is suffering, is joyful, no? Peaceful, no? Nothing is suffering, nobody is suffering, is peaceful, no?
Nobody is suffering, but suffering is there.
But are you, is it affecting you?
Affecting means what, actually?
So?
Like this fan is not affecting.
Oh, no,
like,
no.
Similarly, suffering, if it is there, suffering, whatever the effect is, that is the suffering.
No, no, no.
The effect is suffering.
Is it for you? Is awareness suffering?
No. Awareness is not suffering.
You are that awareness.
Yes.
So if this understanding, you will be able, in a life, you will be able to life, this body-mind complex, you will be able to face in a better way. More peacefully.
That bliss you are talking about? This peaceful is temporary only. This peaceful is temporary. It will go
out,
come.
Why did you study this? Why did you study this? What is this? Huh? Jaga Sangya. Why is it? You are channeling it. Okay. So come back to I am that Shivoham. Nothing is affecting me. The moment you get involved in the image, you start getting stress. You know, you should know how to come back out of the image again and again, right? So that is the entire spiritual teaching. Are you clear? So we'll break for 10 minutes, then continue.